Welcome back to America's Commercial Real Estate Show. I'm Michael Bull. Today, our topic is Frothy Market or Beginning of a Golden Age. This segment is brought to you by ArborCrowd, crowdfunding for the professionals. Visit arborcrowd.com. Well, my guests are Tim Bodker and Byron Carlock, and they're with PwC, and we're talking about, you guys just did a recent report on kind of what's happening in commercial real estate and some of the mergers and acquisitions and what you expect moving forward. And I think our audience, or seems like everyone, is concerned about retail moving forward. So what do you guys see from the Tax Act and the Jobs Act, Tax Reform and Jobs Act? How might that impact retail moving forward?
Sure. So I think the first point to make about retail is that the markets generally put retail all together in one group, and it's really a much more diverse group of or sector that needs to be paid attention to. So I think that's the first point. I think the second point to make is that retail is a sector that's being heavily focused on by the activist investor community, and that's driving what we were a little bit talking about earlier around companies, retailers looking very closely at how they're leveraging their real estate portfolio. So we think the activist investor community is going to drive transaction activity as it relates to retail related businesses. That's the second point. The third point I'd mention is there's a general shift in how real estate is being used around kind of a move from a place where you buy things to where you go for an experience. And so a lot of the retail centers that are in place today, shopping centers, strip centers, et cetera, are being repurposed to create more of an experience for their tenants. And so we're seeing a lot of folks re-tenanting space, reconfiguring space, redeveloping space in order to fit alternative purposes.
And are those places going to see more consumers? How's consumer confidence that you see out there?
Well, you know, 70% of our economy is driven by consumer expectations and confidence, right?
Yeah.
And so if you've got some employers, and the numbers grow every day, that are moving up minimum wage and improving the quality of life of their employees, generally a big piece of that ends up back in the economy through retail activity.
And aren't most employees going to have a little bit more take-home pay here any day?
Supposedly going to be felt in February. I think that's the expectation.
That's right.
Yeah. So what's that do for retail? I mean, if investors are bullish on commercial real estate in general, then should we be bullish on retail moving forward? I mean, I think Americans have proven if you give them money, they'll spend it.
Yeah.
Right. At least my wife does that. Yeah.
The concept being contemplated has to be relevant to people's needs. And I think what we're seeing right now is a sorting out, to Tim's point, of those retailers that offer relevance. Either it's convenience, a great website, easy e-commerce, or a great visit to their store that leaves you with a satisfied experience, if you will, having visited. You need a reason to go visit in a way that you... it justifies your time to stop in and be a guest in that retail bricks and mortar place. 92% of sales are still done in bricks and mortar locations.
That's right.
Yeah.
Well, how do you think all this impacts retail occupancy and performance moving forward and investment and cap rates?
Well, I think to the point we mentioned a little bit earlier, there's certainly going to be those segments of the retail sector that do very well.
Yeah.
Right, and have favorable cap rates, and then there's going to be some that are going to need to be repurposed. So in our emerging trends in real estate report, one of the things we mentioned is just how over-retailed the U.S. is relative to certain other places around the world. 24. So I think when you look at that, there's going to be some parts of retail that are going to be repurposed into something else over a longer period of time.
Right, big redevelopment opportunities. You see already developers taking chances on taking B and C malls and turning them into other uses. You know, Sam Zell in a speech last year, I heard him say retail is not overdeveloped, it's under-demolished.
Yeah.
We've failed to redevelop it into appropriate uses as it's become irrelevant. and yeah. we have to be vigilant about making sure it's relevant.
Yeah. Well, one of the notes in your report here says that consumer spending is really outpacing wage growth. Mm-hmm. So what does that mean for the economy and for retail?
Well, it's a risk, yeah. Right? It's certainly a risk to the economy that trend is present. But I think so long as employment, you know, stays where it's going to be, to the point Byron mentioned earlier about the favorable impact to folks' take-home pay as a result of the Tax Act, then we should be. I think our view is we should see, you know, we should be okay as it relates to consumer spending and confidence.
So let's talk about the impact of rising rates. Mm-hmm. What do you guys think, first of all, for the Fed's plans moving forward? Do you think we're going to have continued interest rate increases in 2018?
We will see. I think the view is we will see future rate increases, primarily because when you look at the indications of inflation in the market, they're going to need to watch that. Having said all that, I think what the Fed has shown is that they're being very thoughtful and careful about how quickly and how much they move rates.
Yeah.
It's good. We may see increases, but they're not going to be significant. I think
small and steady is
exactly
what we're expecting.
Yeah.
And if small and steady, so let's put that into scope here. So are we thinking maybe a quarter basis, 25 basis points each time they meet? Are we thinking maybe in a year that we have a percentage point higher rate, 100 basis points?
I think that's a reasonable expectation.
I think
you hear more and more people talk about stepped 25s, and mm-hmm. maybe there are four of those.
And yeah. So what might that do to cap rates, especially while we're talking about retail? If retail is kind of in a flux and a change, in a changing scope here, what does that do to cap rates for retail properties?
It could cause upward pressure on cap rates, just generally speaking. But the thing that I think we also need to keep in mind is there's a tremendous amount of capital that's out there. In our report, one of the things we cite is the amount of dry powder that's out there, being $249 billion. So that sort of capital on the sideline, coupled with the demand for real estate, given that even though rates are going to move higher, they're still low on a relative basis, and so there's just a significant demand for real estate.
In asset allocation theory, right now real estate is a golden allocation recipient.
Yeah.
And so you see real estate and alternatives along with private equity getting a larger piece of the allocation wheel from individuals, pension funds, institutions, sovereign wealth funds, and then the rising wealth of emerging markets. So we've seen a tremendous amount of capital find an interest in real estate without being able to invest it, to Tim's dry powder point of view.
Yeah.
So in your report, you said that private equity, 263 funds in 2017 raised $109 billion. You know, that's just one example. So you think there is plenty of dry powder, and that's going to maybe keep cap rates in retail properties from rising that much, a lot of buyer demand?
Because capital will I think, keep the cap rates low, actually.
Yeah. And then you're expecting some NOI growth in retail and other properties?
Sure.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
The other thing you mentioned, Michael, just on the dry powder point, one of the things we need to do is segment that between equity-based investors and those who are focused on debt. So, for example, of the private equity funds raised last year, about 28% of those funds were funds focused on commercial debt.
Debt, yeah.
And in the public markets, we had nine IPOs. Five of those were commercial mortgage REITs. So there's been a significant segment of the industry that's been focused on debt, primarily because of really, I would say, kind of three things. One, just where we are in the cycle. Some people just feel more comfortable being in a lender position as opposed to being the equity.
Mm-hmm.
Two is there is still some impacts of regulation out there insofar as
on the
Volcker rule and some of the
holding down.
And then the final thing is just what I would say is that some people think in a rising rate environment, it's good to be an investor in debt. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, certainly we feel safer in the first position.
Yeah.
And if things go bad, maybe you turn out okay, right?
That's right.
Any other final thoughts in this segment for retail moving forward?
Well, the balance of power between retail and industrial cannot be minimized.
Right.
There's a real linkage.
Yeah.
And so we're seeing e-commerce grow 25% a year. And so that's clearly an important growth trajectory to watch, but that's happening. That's some people say warehouses are the next retail because that's where a lot of the activity is.
Yeah.
As we watch traditional bricks and mortar go through its evolution to relevance.
No, I think that's absolutely right. What impact does e-commerce changes in logistics, supply chain, et cetera, on how retailers organize their physical and online presence? So, for example, one of the things we haven't touched on is just the growing influence of showrooming as like an example.
Mm-hmm.
So how do all these things, how do retailers balance their strategy between an online presence and a physical presence is certainly something to watch.
Yeah, it's certainly big today. Well, we're going to take a short break. When we get back, I want to talk to you about multifamily and housing because there's some changes in the tax laws and Jobs Act that could impact residential, and multifamily has really been on a roll. What should we expect moving forward? Stay with us. I'm Michael Bull. This is America's Commercial Real Estate Show.